Today, let us discuss the important gland, that is thyroid gland, which is subtopic in endocrine system. Thyroid gland. This thyroid gland is anabolic in process. Usually this thyroid gland works as anabolic process, but if there is any stressful conditions, it will act as catabolic process. Under only stressful condition. Usually it is anabolic process, but in certain conditions, that is stressful conditions, it leads to catabolic process. There are many important uses of thyroid gland, but majorly there are three important uses of thyroid glands. That is, first important function of this thyroid gland is it helps in maintaining the mental stress. It helps in maintaining the mental stress. This is the first condition, first important function of thyroid gland. Second function of thyroid gland is it also helps in maintaining the physical conditions of body. Second function of thyroid gland is it helps in maintaining the physical conditions of the body. And third most important function of thyroid gland is it involves in maintaining the basal metabolic rate. These are the three important functions which is to be discussed under thyroid gland. Is first one is it involves in maintaining the mental stress. Second one is it involves in maintaining the physical conditions, and third one, it helps in maintaining the basal metabolic rate of our body. And this location of this thyroid gland is it is present down to the larynx. And anterior to the trachea. This anterior part of the trachea, which can be touched with our hands. It is only one of the gland which is present just closer to the skin. And these are some important and basics of thyroid glands. And if we discuss about the structure of thyroid gland, it is butterfly shaped structure. This is the structure of thyroid gland. It consists of two lobes. One is right lobe and this is the left lobe. These two lobes are internally connected by isthmus. This is isthmus. Isthmus is a special connective tissue which connects the left and right hemispheres of this gland. Now, as we know that, let us draw this diagram bigger. Let us consider this is the structure of thyroid gland and this it is a isthmus. These are the two lobes, and the structural and functional unit of thyroid gland is follicular cells. These are the special structural and functional unit of thyroids, thyroid gland, that is follicular cells. And we have to remember that there is not only one follicular cell, there are many number of follicular cells. Like this, there are many number of follicular cells are present in thyroid gland, and these are the follicular cells. And let us assume the blood supply to this let us assume this is the blood capillary system which is present inner side of this thyroid gland. These are the blood vessels, or else these are the capillaries. And one important point to remember is these follicular cells are made up of special type of cells. That special type of cells, these special types of cells are called thyrocytes. These special types of cells are called thyrocytes, and in between the follicular cells and blood vascular system, there are special types of cells. These are the special types of cells. Let us assume these are the special types of cells which are present between the follicular cells and capillaries. These special types of cells are called parafollicular cells. These special types of cells are called parafollicular cells. And if we discuss about the secretions of these cells, these follicular cells will secrete special type of hormones that are T3 and T4, and these parafollicular cells will secrete special type of hormones that is calcitonin. This is some basic information of thyroid gland. And here this is the circulation, and this is the basic information of the thyroid gland. If we discuss about the pathway of this T3 and T4. Let us assume one of the thyroid cell Here, this is a cardiovascular system. And this is a blood supply towards the thyroid cells. And there are three different types of membranes in this thyrocytes. Now, these membrane which is facing towards the circulatory system, this membrane is called basal membrane. This membrane is called basal membrane, and the membrane which is present at these sites . These membranes are called lateral membranes. This is a basal membrane and these are the lateral membranes. And the layer which is present towards the lumen side, that is, this is a lumen. This special membrane is called apical membrane or luminal membrane. These are the three membranes of thyrocytes. This is a basal membrane which is facing towards the cardiovascular blood supply, and these are the lateral membranes, and it is a apical membrane or also called luminal membrane, which is facing towards the lumen. Now, the main function of these thyrocytes are to synthesize T3 and T4 cells. The main function of this is to synthesize T3 hormone and T4 hormone. Now, there are many steps in the synthesis of T3 and T4. The first step in this is it will absorb the raw materials from blood supply. It will absorb the raw materials from the blood supply. From the blood supply, this is the first step. Now, the raw materials are like iodides. These are the iodides, which are also considered as the raw materials for the synthesis of triiodothyronine and tetraiodothyronine. Now, these iodides are observed. This is the first step. Now, these iodides are observed from bloodstream into the interstitial space. Now, the iodides which are present in the interstitial space has to transfer into the thyrocytes, but these iodides are impermeable to this basal membrane. Now, there is a special pumps or proteins for the transfer of these iodides into the inner cell. These are the special proteins, are also called iodide pumps. These iodide pumps helps in transfer of these iodides which are present in interstitial area. Now it will be transferred into the inner side of this membrane. That is thyrocytes. This is the first step, and this is the second step. Now, here also it is same. Iodides will be coming inner side. It is iodides. Now, the iodides will be entered inner side of these thyrocytes, and it will accumulate in this area. Now, these iodides will be situated, or it will reach the apical membrane. Now, as we know that this is the lumen, and these iodides will reach this apical membrane, and here there is a special enzyme or protein which have many functions. Out of which the first function is it will convert this iodide form into iodine. There is a special enzyme the name of this enzyme is tyrosine peroxidase. The function name is tyrosine peroxidase. Now, the first function of the tyrosine peroxidase is it will convert the iodide form into iodine form. That is oxidation of iodide form into iodine. That is oxidation of iodides, where iodide form will get converted into iodine form. This is the first function. Now, here, this is the first function. Now, if we discuss about the second function, as we know that these thyrocytes consist of nucleus. Inside the nucleus, there is a genome or genetic material which is also present in it. Let us assume this is the nucleus. This nucleus consists of genetic material. Now, this genetic material will undergo transcription process, will result in formation of mRNA. it results in formation of mRNA. Now this mRNA will undergo translation process, will result in the formation of special protein. Let us assume this is a protein. This is a special protein which is produced, and it consists of several different types of amino acids. Example, these are different types of amino acids, and the predominant type of amino acid which is present is tyrosine. The predominant type of amino acid is tyrosine, and there are several different types of amino acids along with tyrosine. Now this special type of protein is called thyroglobulin. This special structure is called thyroglobulin. Now this thyroglobulin, from the inner side of these thyrocytes, has to move into the lumen cells. Now with the help of tyrosine peroxidase, this thyroglobulin will be moved to the lumen side. Let us assume this in the lumen. This is 5 prime and this is 3 prime. As we know that there are different types of amino acids. Different types of amino acids are present, and the predominant type of amino acid is tyrosine. This is a predominant type, that is tyrosine. Or else, this is 5 prime and this is 3 prime. This is the thyroglobulin which is synthesized in inner side of these thyrocytes and will be moved from inner side to the lumen. Now this is the first function, that is conversion of iodide form into iodine form. Now the second function of this tyrosine peroxidase is this iodine which is liberated will be bind to the these tyrosine molecules. Let us assume this is one iodine molecule and it consists of two iodine molecules. One iodine is attached to one tyrosine and two iodines are attached to this another tyrosine molecule. This is a second function. This is the first function and this is the second function. And whenever this, let us count 1, 2, 3, there are three iodine molecules which are attached. Now this tyrosine molecule in which one iodine is attached, it is called monoiodothyronine. It is called monoiodothyronine. And the tyrosine in which two iodine molecules are attached. That is called diiodothyronine. Diiodothyronine. Once again, here three iodine molecules are attached, in which one iodine is attached to one tyrosine and two iodine molecules are attached to another tyrosine. Now the tyrosine in which only one iodine is attached is called monoiodothyronine, and the tyrosine in which two iodine molecules are attached is called diiodothyronine. And the third function of this tyrosine peroxidase is it helps in coupling of this monoiodothyronine and diiodothyronine. Hence these two tyrosine molecules will be coupled to each other. It forms special structure. This special structure in which monoiodothyronine and diiodothyronine are coupled each other to form triiodothyronine. Triiodothyronine. This triiodothyronine is also called T3. This is a synthesis of T3. This is the second function, and this is a synthesis of T3, and these iodines, next which are remaining iodine molecules, it will get attached to the tyrosine molecules. Let us assume here two iodine molecules are attached, and here two iodine molecules are attached. Here two iodine molecules are attached, and here two iodine molecules are attached. Now this special entire structure is called diiodothyronine, and this structure is also called diiodothyronine. Now this diiodothyronine is tyrosine in which two iodine molecules are attached to it, and here also same two iodine molecules are attached to it. Now the third function of this tyrosine peroxidase is it will also couples the these two diiodothyronine molecules. Coupling reaction. Now these two will be coupled to each other. It results in formation of special protein. Now this diiodothyronine and diiodothyronine couples to each other, and it results in formation of tetraiodothyronine. Tetraiodothyronine. This tetraiodothyronine is also called T4. In this way, this T3 and T4 are synthesized with the help of thyroglobulin. And in same way, in the parafollicular cells, it is also consists of thyrocytes, and it results in formation of calcitonin. Now the main function of this calcitonin is whenever the calcium levels in the blood are increased, this calcitonin will be released. The main function of this calcitonin is to decrease the calcium levels in the blood. It will decrease the calcium levels inside of the blood. This is the main function. And there are two disorders which regarding with this thyroid gland, that is, if the iodide, the raw materials like iodide molecules are less in number, and the intake of these iodide molecules are lesser, then it is called hypothyroidism. And second condition is if there are excess amount of iodide molecules which are taken up by these thyrocytes and production of T3 and T4 and calcitonin, it is called hyperthyroidism. These are the two conditions which are related to this thyroid gland, that is hypothyroidism and hyperthyroidism. Here the intake of iodide molecules will be less, and here the intake of iodide molecules will be more. This is about thyroid gland. And if we discuss about parathyroid gland, this parathyroid gland This is the structure of thyroid gland, and there are a pair of parathyroid glands on either sides of this lobes. These are the four parathyroid glands. These parathyroid glands will secrete a special type of hormone, that is parath hormone. The main function of this parath hormone is, whenever the calcium levels in our blood will be decreases, this parath hormone will be comes into action, and it will increase the calcium levels inside the blood by participating in demineralization of bones. These are the some important terms of this thyroid gland.